सी सी प्लस प्लस सी शार्प जावास्क्रिप्ट जावा रूबी पाइथन पास्कल पीएचपी .NET सो मेनी लैंग्वेजेस सो हाउ डू यू नो विच वन यू शुड लर्न फर्स्ट वेल दैट्स व्हाट वी आर गोना आंसर इन दिस वीडियो डिसाइडिंग विच लैंग्वेज यू शुड लर्न फर्स्ट कैन बी क्वाइट कंफ्यूजिंग व्हेन यू स्टार्टिंग आउट ट्रस्ट मी व्हेन आई से देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ चॉइसेस एंड नॉट एवरी लैंग्वेज इज सूटेबल फॉर यूज इन एवरी फील्ड फॉर एग्जाम्पल You could try and use C for machine learning, but it's going to give you nightmares. On the other hand, if you use Python, it's going to be much, much smoother because it has libraries that are made specifically for machine learning. So in this video, we'll break down some of the most popular choices and also figure out which language suits you the best. All the programming languages have their own purpose in their own field. So while starting out, I think it's better if you try and figure out what it is you might like to do. For example, would you like to make games or would you like to make apps? Would you like to make websites? That sort of thing. But a general opinion is that you should learn C first. C is supposed to be like the foundation of all programming languages, meaning if you learn C properly first, then you can learn any other programming language easily. But the thing is, I don't think that's entirely accurate. If you learn your first programming language properly, any programming language, then you'll always have an easier time learning another language. For example, the first language I learned wasn't C, it was in fact Python. So my point is that even though I learned Python first, I never really felt like I was at a disadvantage compared to others who learned C first. If anything, it actually felt like a bit of an advantage. The reason is Python is much more advanced than C. Python actually supports concepts like object-oriented programming, while C doesn't. So you see what I mean? It's not like the first language you learn is going to shape your career, but the way it can affect you is your interest. If you pick the wrong language and you don't like it, you might probably lose interest in coding itself. So that's why, let's take a look at some languages now. Number one, for game development. If you want to learn how games are made from scratch, what actually goes on behind the screen, and what happens when you press a button on your keyboard, then you should learn either C# or C++. These two are the most popular languages that are used for game development right now. But before learning C++, I would advise learning C# first. The reason is, in game development, C++ actually gets a lot more complicated than it already is. So if you learn C# first, along with the fundamentals of game development, the journey might actually get a lot easier. Number two is app development. App development is a field where a lot of languages are used. So to make it easier to understand, let me break it down. For Android apps, learn Java and Kotlin. For iOS apps, learn Swift. And for apps that will work on both iOS and Android, learn JavaScript. App development will also require some scripting languages like XML, but we'll cover that in another video. And the third one is web development. This is one of the most popular fields in computer science, and it actually uses a combination of languages just like app development. So I'll break it down for you again. To make the front end of a website, which is what you can actually see on the screen, learn HTML and then CSS. And to make the back end, which is the calculation part of the website, learn JavaScript. I know this can sound like a lot if you're new to coding, but trust me, it's really not that hard. First, learn the basics of HTML. And once you're comfortable with it, learn CSS. Once you learn HTML and CSS, you can easily make the front end of any website in the world. And then go ahead and start learning the back end, which is JavaScript. And the last field that we are going to cover in this video is data science and machine learning. Although I have added this field in this video, I highly recommend that you do not start with it. The reason being, it's extremely hard. It involves a lot of complex coding, complicated logic and math, and it's very confusing. But if you still want to start with it, learn Python, R and MATLAB. So this was if you already know which field you want to go with. But what if you're like me when I started out and don't really know what you exactly like? You just want to play around and dabble with everything that you can come across and find what interests you. So for that reason, I would say learn Python. It's widely accepted as the best first language to learn, and there's good reason for it. It's extremely easy to learn, extremely easy to deploy, and it's extremely versatile. Meaning, you can learn everything from building games to websites using just one programming language. That's Python. So with Python, you can try out as many things as you like and find out what really interests you. But like I always say in my videos, don't just go on learning languages. After you finish learning a language, work on some projects with it. Just so that you learn how to make real-world projects by coding. This will give you an idea of how things are actually built. So for example, if you just learned a new language like Java, A really good project is building a small calculator. You can work with a bunch of things like conditions, functions, classes, and operators. And after learning a new language and getting comfortable with it, if you want to learn another programming language within 2 weeks, check this video out. So anyways, that was it for this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to this channel. That'll keep me motivated to make good videos for you guys. So until next time, happy learning.